Jonas and I met in Berlin. It was the summer of 2018 at this party for just girls that Jonas had snuck into. And I found that kind of ballsy, and after talking for a while, we agreed to get together and write. We quite quickly found a musical connection, and very soon after that, we'd made plans to go to Spain and write some more. We went there with producer Alexander Hauer, and the idea was to write for others. But when we started recording the demos, we kind of liked the sound that we had together. So that's how the whole idea behind Shandel and Samuel started. After a week in Spain, we came home to Berlin with enough material for a whole EP, so we decided to just go ahead and record it. We hooked up with Simonne Jones, this amazing DJ producer from LA, and we booked 8 days in her studio where everything was recorded. It was mostly organic, with loads of vocal harmonies and our guitars, and of course Simone's magic touch on top. We signed a record deal with DaWorks in Oslo, and in November our first song, Heroin, came out. The second single, Gold, came in February, and then in May, the first EP called Castaway. Not much had happened till then, really, but with the single Desert Island, we gained some airplay and all of a sudden landed on the German radio charts for the summer. And luckily, we had taken another trip to Spain in the springtime and written some more songs, recorded some video clips. We got the songs produced by the Beatgees and Brosch. So we had enough material for a whole album. We'd also recorded 3 live videos at Studio One in Berlin, with Katie on the keyboards and Christoph Lee behind the camera, and Harrison Silver Fox recording it. On a desert island, I would need a whole lot more. Just a little wilding on a desert island, I would need a whole lot more. And I wanna know, would you go? Then came the lockdown. And then we were stuck in 2 different countries. Everything got cancelled. All our plans to go traveling. And there was just no easy way to promote the EP. It definitely made the whole process a lot harder, constantly sending stuff back and forth for approval, finishing all the videos, getting all the artwork done, being in a long distance relationship is hard, but try being in a long distance band. That's a challenge. But we are fighters. And somehow we have actually managed to finish the album, and we just cannot wait to show it to you guys soon. We strongly want to start off 2021 on a high note. And so our next single, White Horse, is gonna drop on New Year's Eve 2020, followed by an album in January. It's called In the Green, and it is very sad that we cannot go on the road and meet you guys right now, but hopefully we'll all be patient and hopefully you'll stay tuned. And then as soon as we can, we promise to come play for you wherever you are.